Thanks for clicking on the video. Hit the subscribe button for more weekly content, and hit the notification bell so you won't miss a thing. How would this story go if Koji and Koichi were reunited since the beginning? What's good, people? What's poppin'? How are you doing? And welcome to a brand new video. This particular scenario is one that's been on my mind for a very long time, since I started doing What If videos. Would the course of Frontier change that much if the legendary Warrior of Darkness was introduced earlier? We'll just have to explore and see. I want to also do more What Ifs that are Digimon related, since you guys vibe with those the most. Let me know some ideas you all might have down below. Since this is the first part, if this video gets 20 likes, I know you want the story to continue. With that out of the way, let's get started. Our story begins with not Takuya ditching his little brother's birthday because a strange lady told him to, but with Koichi at his grandmother's deathbed. Before passing away, she informs him that he has a younger twin brother named Koji. He goes on to observe his brother and his family all the way to the day Koji and the rest of the Digidestin head to Shibuya Station. All plays out just as it did in the original, except this time, Koichi never trips and collapses. He manages to just barely make the train his brother was on. He spent the first 30 seconds hunched over, catching his breath, but as soon as he looked up, he caught the eyes of a speechless Koji.
"Who are you?"
"My name is Koichi, and I'm your brother."
"Brother?"
But before Koji could continue, the train abruptly took off, and after looking around, the two noticed that they were the only passengers on board. It wasn't long until they realized that this was no ordinary train. After the initial shock, Koji, still skeptical, shot right back at Koichi.
"What do you mean that you're my brother? I'm an only child."
Koichi then went on to explain everything that their grandmother revealed to him, the circumstances of their parents' divorce, and how the boys were split up as well. Of course, this was a lot for Koji to process, but by the time he had time to, they were already at the stop, the flame terminal. By this point, Takuya and the others had already had their encounter with Suberimon, and the story of the legendary warriors had begun. And now we're at the point when Koji is instructed to find his spirit. The events here play out the same, with Koji having to save the day and find the human spirit of light. And just like before, Koji left the group before they could thank him properly. At least Koichi was here to apologize on his behalf before catching up with him. The story continues without any changes until all of the kids, except Koichi, have their spirits. During their travels, Koji and Koichi didn't really click. The two never knew about each other until just recently. Koji accepted the fact that he was his brother, but it was not like he knew what it was like to be a brother. Koichi was in the same boat. He was the older brother, but since he doesn't have a spirit, Koji oftentimes had to make sure he was safe. That didn't really sit well with him. That brings us to their first encounter with Grumblemon. The brothers are still traveling alone when they come to the Kartsuki Numamon Mountain. Hearing the cries of the captured female Kartsuki Numamon, Koji and Koichi try to save them, only for the both of them to be knocked off by the mountain mysteriously. We continue as per normal. The others offer to help the male Kartsuki Numamon in exchange for food. They find Koji and Koichi, who further explains the situation, and the snail Digimon become unnerved after finding out that they are the legendary warriors. Not long after, the children find themselves hanging from the mountain, held hostage by the male Kartsuki Numamon, thinking they're allied with the one responsible for this whole mess, the evil legendary warrior Grumblemon. A fight like before ensues, with everyone's spirit evolving to take on the evil Digimon. He appears to be too much for them, as he has access to a more powerful beast spirit, and was able to steal the mountain's fractal code, per his plan. With the mountain destroyed, the shock separated the falling heroes. Takuya, Koji, and Tommy are in one group, while Zoe, JP, and Koichi are in the other. Overall, the boys' adventure on the Island of Toys doesn't change much at all. However, Koji does want to know how to be a brother, since finding out he has one. He sees Takuya treating Tommy like his own little brother, and Koji wonders what his life would have been like if Koichi was with him. Speaking of Koichi, so far, it doesn't seem like his presence is making any difference in the story thus far. Sure, Koji's gone softer quicker, but that's about it. I'm trying to keep with the canon as much as possible, which is why he's still the only one without his spirit. For those that need a refresher in the lore of Frontier, after the Great War, the three great angel Digimon gained possession of the spirits of the legendary warriors. Seraphimon had two, Afaniamon had three, while Cherubimon possessed the other five, to include the spirit of darkness. However, I do believe his time to shine is approaching. After the events on the Island of Toys, the Digimon School, and with Bakuman, all of the Digidestin are reunited. Koji gets word from his detector that his beast spirit is close. He tries to leave the group in the middle of the night like before, but Koichi manages to convince him to go with the entire group. Koji was hesitant, but he ultimately relented and gave in to his elder brother's wishes. In the end, it just didn't feel right ditching him or the others. Come morning, the group traverses the forest and find a Gatsumon looking for the jewel to unlock the spirit. The young Digimon gives the Digidestin to slip, only to find him in his village as under attack by Gigasmon. Everyone's spirit evolves to protect from this threat, but their superior numbers were still no match for the more experienced beast. Koji doesn't get knocked out this time, but Gigasmon's strength still forces them on the defensive. With a powerful strike, Gigasmon knocks the fractal code out of Kumamon and attempts to steal his spirit. Koichi, though still a human, without thinking, jumped in front of Kumamon to take the hit, exposing his own fractal code. Though very annoyed, Gigasmon didn't bother stealing it since it was without a spirit. Everyone was stunned by what happened to Koichi, but Lobamon went into a blind fury, using said rage to push back Gigasmon while the others tend to his brother. This fight, however, went back to Gigasmon as he still had the advantage in raw power, pummeling Lobamon until he reverted back to Koji. Gatsumon, thinking quickly, used the jewel he found to unlock the sealed spirit. Before Gigasmon could end Koji for good, spirit floats in front of him, and Koji, knowing what it is, uses it to spirit evolve into Kendo Garurumon. The battle between the two beast spirits ends as it did originally, with Koji unable to control his power and unintentionally blowing away Gigasmon. Afterwards, Koji hurries to check on his brother. The others inform him that Koichi's fractal code returned to normal, and he'll be just fine. For the first time ever, they see Koji give off a genuine smile. And that's a good place to end this part. A couple takeaways. Though slow, it does seem that Koichi's early introduction to the team is making some changes. Koji is nowhere near as cold to the group, and some of you all probably picked up that Zoe never got her spirit stolen this time. Though he has yet to possess his spirits, Koichi might actually propel the story on a different path. So what do you all think? Do you think Koichi's early addition to the team will have any more major impacts to the established story? Thank you guys for taking the time to watch this video. Let me know what you guys think in the comments down below, and give me some more ideas for what ifs that you would like to see come to life on this channel. Thank you guys, and I'll catch you guys in the next video. Bye!